Today, we'll continue with the reactivity series. Okay, what do we know so far of the reactivity series? Potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, and what we learned in the previous video is that carbon comes between aluminium and zinc. Now today, what we're going to do is we're going to find out where hydrogen is. Okay, now after zinc, iron, tin, lead, copper, silver, gold. We already know that carbon is here. But where is hydrogen? So the only way to know where hydrogen is to compare hydrogen with all the other metals and to see the reactivity towards oxygen. Okay, now as you know, hydrogen is a gas. So in order to react with a gas, we need to have a burning tube. Okay, so let's see the experiment required. So what we do is, here we have our metal oxides. Okay, so for example, you put magnesium oxide and what happens is you flow a constant flow of hydrogen. Okay, now what happens is we want the hydrogen to constantly flow through this. So in order for the hydrogen to constantly flow through this, you need to have a flame here that burns the excess hydrogen. Okay, so the excess hydrogen is burnt. Now, the magnesium oxide will not react with hydrogen gas if it's cold. So what happens is, to the magnesium oxide, you have to heat it up. Okay, so what happens is, we do this experiment. We allow hydrogen gas to be flowed through very, very hot magnesium oxide. And we wait. We wait and we wait and we wait. But there is no reaction. So, if there is no reaction, it means that magnesium is more reactive than hydrogen. Okay, so what we do is we start all over again. And instead of using magnesium oxide, we use another metal. Okay, remember, the apparatus is the same. We flow hydrogen gas. Here we burn the excess hydrogen. Here we put a metal oxide. So this time, we try zinc oxide. We allow zinc oxide to react with very hot zinc oxide to react with hydrogen. But again, there is no reaction. So that means zinc is also more reactive than hydrogen. We try again. This time, we put iron oxide. And now a reaction occurs. What happens is, the reddish brown iron oxide slowly turns to shiny gray as hydrogen gas flows through it. This is because iron oxide has been reduced to iron by hydrogen. So iron oxide plus hydrogen, you get iron plus water. Over here, some water droplets will start to form. Okay, so this proves that hydrogen is more reactive than iron. So let's go back to the beginning. The position of hydrogen is here. Hydrogen is more reactive than iron, but less reactive than zinc. That means hydrogen is able to remove oxygen from iron oxide, tin oxide, lead oxide, copper oxide. The most common question is they will ask you about copper oxide. This is because of the color. So the apparatus will be like this. The same apparatus. Here we put copper oxide. Now you have to remember, copper oxide is black and we flow hydrogen gas. Now what happens is the black copper oxide will slowly turn to copper, which is shiny brown. The reaction is this: copper oxide reacts with hydrogen to form copper and water. And here you will have some water droplets. So what is the reaction that happens? Is this redox? Yes. Copper oxide is reduced to copper and hydrogen is oxidized to water. Okay, so this is a redox reaction. All right, so most important that you learn today is that in the metal reactivity series, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, carbon, zinc, hydrogen, iron, tin, lead, copper, silver, gold. Okay, so this is not for electrons, it's not for electricity. Remember, it is the reactivity of these metals towards oxygen. Okay, see you.